Anybody know that one? What? Amen. Praise the Lord. I'm thinking y'all know the second thing. Amen. Happy resurrection.
We love you.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Jesus. Jesus. Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Morning, Serenity.
Amen. Morning.
This is a good day.
Amen.
I just want to thank the Lord for what He has done for us.
Yes.
Based on this Resurrection Sunday.
Amen.
I mean, it is a great honor to know that how much the Lord loved us.
Yes.
And how much God cared for us.
Yes,
Lord. First fruit that He sent His Son, O Calvary, to die for our sins.
Amen.
And us being joined together to magnify His holy name.
Yes.
Let us know that we are joined together with Him.
Amen.
Because of what He done for us at
Jesus.
Calvary.
Yeah.
Yes.
I just want to thank the Lord this morning for that.
Amen.
That is very important to us, that we are joined together amongst the brothers and sisters.
Yes.
To commemorate this day for what the Lord has done for us.
Yeah. Amen.
And I want to thank Him this morning.
Thank God. Yes.
Because God didn't have to do that.
Yes.
And He loves us so much.
Yes.
Unconditionally.
Yes.
No matter our sins.
Amen.
Because Jesus knew that
yes.
there was someone that could get it right.
Amen.
And He said, I'm going to die for those that did do it right.
Yes.
Yes.
So that being said, this morning, good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. And good morning.
Good morning.
Amen.
Because He lives.
Amen.
I can face tomorrow.
Amen.
Because He lives. All fear is gone.
Amen.
Because I can face tomorrow. That's
Amen.
Because He lives. You know, somebody asked me, they said, can I get a witness? Can Jesus get a witness?
All right.
Yeah, He can get a witness. Because Amen. You know what? He lives inside.
Amen.
And that's the witness that He lives.
Amen.
Amen.
Because I live.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Because I live.
We will now have our responsive reading. I'll be the leader.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. As for me, I will call upon God, and the Lord shall save me.
Yes.
Evening and morning and at noon will I pray and cry aloud.
Amen.
He shall hear my voice. He hath delivered my soul in peace from the battle that was against me.
Amen.
For there were many with me.
He cared for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your request be made known unto God, and the peace of God, which passes all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus.
Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. They shall prosper that love thee. Peace be within thy walls and prosperity within thy palaces. For my brother and companion's sake, I will now say peace be within
you. Yes, Lord.
Because of the house of the Lord,
yes.
my God, I
yes.
will seek thy good.
Only be thou strong and very courageous. That thou mayest learn to do according to all the law, which Moses my servant commanded thee. Turn not from it to the right hand, or to the left, that thou mayest prosper whithersoever thou goest. This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest learn to do according to all that is written therein. And then thou shalt have
thy way prosperous,
and then thou shalt have good success.
Lord saying, stay connected, family.
Amen.
I am the vine, and ye are the branches.
Yes, Lord.
He that abideth in me,
yes,
and
Lord.
I in him, the
yes.
same bringeth forth much fruit.
Yes.
For without me, ye can do nothing.
Amen.
I can do all things through Christ which strengthened me.
Trust
in the Lord with all thy heart. Lead not to thy own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he will direct thy paths. Be not wise in thy own eyes. Fear the Lord and depart from evil.
Amen. 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 We now prepare for our tithe and offering.
Yes.
Amen.
Surrender, what time is it?
Offering time.
Follow the directions of your ushers.
Thank you.
Father God, we want to thank you for this money, Lord, that you have blessed us with, Father. We are now returning it back to you, Father, for the uplifting and the building of your kingdom, Father. We want to ask you, Lord, to turn this money from a temple use and turn it into a spiritual use, Lord, for the building of your people. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
We will not have a selection from our choir.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
I know it was a lie. I know it was a lie. I know it was a lie.
I know it was a blood.
Everything gonna be alright.
Amen.
Man, he hung it here and he died.
Yes, he died.
Just for me.
Yes.
But the one thing about it,
now, what's that mean?
He got up.
Resurrection meant to us.
Yes.
You know what where we were and where we would have been in light of what he's done for us. Yes. You know that we would not have a chance in the world if it had not been for the Lord.
Amen.
Yes. On our side. Yes. We thought it not robbery to come down from heaven, to be born of a woman, of a virgin at that.
Yes.
Amen. And go through all he had to go through on this earth for us. How he did miracles and fed the sick, and how he healed the sick, and how he fed the hungry.
Jesus.
And then how those same people that he healed and the same people that he fed crucified him on the cross at Calvary. Yes. Amen. A horrible death. And he did that just for me.
Yes. Amen.
I don't know why Jesus loves me.
Yes.
I don't know why he cares. I don't know why he sacrificed his life.
Oh,
what?
So glad he did.
Amen. Because he did what he did, I owe him my life.
Yeah.
I owe him nothing but my best.
Yeah.
You owe him your life.
Yeah. Amen.
You owe him nothing but your best.
Yeah.
Our children owe him his life.
Amen.
So it's up to us not just to live this life for Jesus, but actually allow our flesh to die in such a way that when our children and those that are looking up to us see us, that seed of that fleshly death can
be resurrected into new life for these babies that are in there.
Amen.
That's what it's all about.
Amen.
The resurrection was all about. Jesus was trying to give us the equation. He was trying to give us the problem and then provide the solution for us.
Amen.
The solution is that we were lost without God. We were dead in the world without Him.
Amen.
But the solution was that He gave His life that we might live.
Yes, He
did.
Amen. So I want to make sure that if I'm supposed to be like Jesus, that I'm living like the man.
Amen.
And I'm walking like that. I'm talking like that. Yes. Amen. Because I know that I can't live this life in this flesh and for myself. I got to live it for Christ that other people can see me and say, what must I do to be saved?
Yes. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. I want to give honor to everyone in the house.
Amen. Amen.
To
Amen.
All the elders in the house, to Pastor Wayne and Sister Chan. I don't want to get to call them all the names because I'll miss somebody. But you know who you are. Amen.
Yes.
All the elders, ministers, deacons, evangelists, prophetess. All the people, the health ministry, all y'all.
Yeah.
I love y'all. All the people that just got dressed and came today just because you love God.
Amen.
God for you. Amen.
Yeah.
And thank God for my lovely wife.
Amen.
Amen. I tell you what, so I don't, I'm not much for form of fashion. I'm a get it done kind of guy.
Amen.
You know? So I just want to get into the word. Is that okay?
Amen.
Amen.
Right. Well, Father, we just thank you. For everything that's already been said and done.
Yes, Lord.
Yes.
Amen. I thank God for the people of God that have faith in you to the point to where they'll put down their calendars. They'll put down what they have going on.
Jesus.
And they'll get dressed and come in the house to give you what they know that you deserve.
Amen.
Which is their very best. So
Amen.
Put down upon us today, God, and receive our praise to you on today.
Yeah.
Let it become as a sweet smelling savor in your nostrils.
Yeah.
And then bless in kind. Jesus. We thank you in advance.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. 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 Amen.
So look, John 12:24 says this. Verily, verily, I say unto you.
Yeah.
Except the corn of wheat fall to the ground and die, it abides alone.
Yeah.
But if it dies,
right,
it brings forth much fruit.
Much fruit.
That's not the scripture that we're going to be talking about today. But this is, to me, the whole life of Jesus is pretty much wound up in this scripture. But he came for a purpose. His only purpose was to come and to die for us that we might have the right to the tree of life.
Amen.
Because up to that point, they've been sacrificing bulls, they've been sacrificing goats, you're sacrificing everything else, and all that has become a stink in the nostrils of God. So God said, no longer am I going to allow you to sacrifice that way.
Mm-hmm.
But what I'm going to do is I'm going to provide myself a lamb.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to wrap myself in human flesh and come down and die for you. That way we can be at peace again, at one again with God. Amen.
Amen.
Through the blood of Jesus. So if you give me just a few seconds today, I want to just talk with you. I might not even preach a whole lot, but I would like to teach from the subject, the power of the resurrection.
Amen.
Hidden in plain sight.
Mm-hmm.
Hidden in plain sight.
Mm-hmm.
We get up on Sunday morning, on Easter Sunday, and we get dressed in our finest clothes. Amen. And that's good. And we're excited. We get the baby's Easter baskets all set out with a little white basket with the green grass and a little plastic eggs filled with all kinds of candy and baby beans and all kinds. And we feel like that is what Easter is all about.
Jesus.
Amen. We hear about the death of Christ on the cross and the resurrection. And all that is perfect in its place. But what I want to know is, where did we go from there?
Amen.
Where do we move from the story of the resurrection and to how it applies to our everyday life? What do I do now that he died? What do I do now?
Amen.
And I think that if we're not careful, the church will set up a skeleton of something that we think that the world needs, and when we miss all the fine details, we'll give them a skeleton and we won't put the meat on the bones to tell folks, now that this has happened, this is what you need to do.
Amen.
And that's what we're going to talk about today.
Amen.
The power of the resurrection that's hidden in plain sight.
Mm-hmm.
If you have your Bible, turn to John, the 20th chapter. We're going to start at verse 19 I'm going to read down to verse 23. Then we're going to come back and we're going to unpack this thing. All right? Talking about the power of the resurrection. What was the power of the resurrection? And now you might be able to take this message and take it home and do some things to it and make it sound something totally different. But for us today, this is what it means. All right? All right, here we go. John 20. Then the same day at evening, being the first day of the week, when the doors were shut where the disciples were assembled, for fear of the Jews. Now, Jesus had just died on the cross.
Amen.
And the Roman soldiers had come, they had taken him, they killed him, and now the Jews were afraid that they might be next.
Yeah.
And then came Jesus, and stood in the midst, and said unto them, peace be unto you. And when he had so said, he showed unto him his hands and his side. And then were the disciples glad when they saw the Lord.
Amen.
Then said Jesus unto them again, peace be unto you. As my Father has sent me, so I send you. And we have said this. He did what?
Yeah.
He breathed on them. And said unto them, what, let everybody say that last part real loud.
Receive ye the Holy Ghost.
Can we say that one more time?
Receive ye the Holy Ghost.
Take a deep breath, fill your lungs, and say it one more time.
Receive ye the Holy Ghost.
Somebody tell your neighbor, that's power. That's power right
there. Amen. Power. Amen.
That's power right there. Whosoever sins ye remit, they are remitted unto them.
Amen.
And whosoever sins you retain, they are retained. Amen. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
The word of God, you can have your seats in the presence of the Lord. And we're just going to go to work. We're not going to be here very long today. I just want to say what the Lord says without any form, fashion, entertainment. I just want to give us the pure, unadulterated word of God.
Amen.
John 20 and 19 begins and he says, in the same day at evening, when being the first day of the week, when the doors were shut, the disciples were assembled for fear of the Jews, and Jesus stood in the midst. Now, you got to understand how crazy that sounds to me right now, because they were locked in the room, and Jesus wasn't there.
Right.
But then he was. How did that happen? And we can theologians describe how he had a glorified body. He came into the room to where they were sitting. But I want to know, is there anybody in this room on today that has ever been in a situation in your life where things got so bad for you and you were ready to give up? But then Jesus showed up.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Jesus showed up in the middle of the room for the disciples. Just like he showed up in your situation.
Yes, Lord.
Just like he showed up in your circumstance. And that reminds me of the book of Revelation where John was at his wit's end because he found that no one was worthy to open up the book of life.
Amen.
He had been living this life with God all this time. He had been through so much. And now he gets to the end of his life and he says nobody was found worthy to open the book.
Amen.
And he said he wept much.
Yes.
But then the angel said, look, see that you don't do that. Cut that out. Why? He said, because he said, as he looked, he said, and in the midst of the throne, in the midst of the 40 elders, in the midst of the beast, that seemed like there was a lamb that had been slain, yet he lived.
Yeah.
Man.
There's a God that was resurrected just for you.
Amen.
He said, that lamb that looked at him, he was slain, he said, he's a root of David, the offspring of Jesse, and he had prevailed to open the book.
Mm-hmm.
And he prevailed to open it for you too, y'all.
Amen, amen.
Jesus prevailed in your singleness.
Yes.
Jesus prevails even in your raggedy marriage sometimes.
Yes.
Jesus prevails even when you gotta look up to see down. He prevails in the midst of our addiction.
Yeah.
He prevails in the midst of our issues with our children. Jesus prevails for you, and he stands.
believe.
Do we still believe that?
Yes, sir.
We have so many Christians that go through life with hung down heads. Mm. And sometimes life is going to do that to you.
Amen.
But when you realize that you're in a room and life has locked you behind the door, remember that Jesus is in the midst of that room. Just
my Lord.
He's in the midst of it all. And he spoke to him and said, peace be unto you.
Yeah.
And then when he had said that, he did something after that. The Bible says he did what? He showed it to him. His hands?
Yes.
And
his side.
What happened to his hands, y'all?
He pierced.
They pierced his hands, right?
Yeah.
What happened to his side? They pierced his side. And it tells, and I feel in my sanctified soul that the scripture, the word is speaking to us today, that says there will be some signs to your resurrection. Someone will be able to put their hands and the scars of your testimony for the glory of God.
Yeah. Amen.
If we hadn't been through nothing, we can't tell nobody.
Good God about it. You right.
Yes.
Yeah. Sure enough.
And the things that we have gone through, while they happened to us, a lot of times it wasn't even for us.
Amen. Amen.
Somebody to be able to touch you and know that if you made it, I can make it too.
Amen.
It's a testimony that speaks, and that's what Jesus is doing right now. He's allowing the testimony of what he's been through speak for them.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes, Lord.
Y'all know what a testimony is? Mm-hmm. You know what a test is.
Yeah.
But a moaning comes from the word mono, meaning one. Mm-hmm. A test just for one. Huh. A test just for you.
Amen.
It's a test that only you use. It's a test that was designed expressly for you. Amen. Because we know that the Lord ain't going to put more on it than we can bear, even though it seems sometimes that test is designed just for you to operate it to the glory of God.
Yeah.
So I can take that time where I lost my job and they gave me that piece of it, and I can operate that thing, and I can come over here to somebody that's having a hard time, and I say, you know what? I lost my job too. I didn't know what I was going to do.
But
I thought I was going to have to sell it all.
Yeah.
Right.
But God.
But God.
Somebody say that loud. Say, but God.
But God.
That's right. Our testimony has got to work to the glory of God. I was an alcoholic.
Yeah.
Look, I don't try to hide the things that I know that God wants to use.
Amen.
I don't mean I got to go blab it to everybody. But there's going to be certain situations and circumstances that God's going to put me in expressly that my testimony and what I went through would give him glory.
Amen.
So I can come up to him and say, just put your hand in my side.
Amen.
Come on, put your hands in the hole. Put your fingers in the holes of my hands.
Yes.
I've been through some stuff.
Been there.
But because I made it, because God allowed me to come through, you can come through.
Amen.
Somebody shout with all your mouth, I'm going to make it.
I'm going to make it.
Come on. We're overcome by the blood of the Lamb and by the
word.
Y'all, you're sure?
Yeah.
We overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the
word.
It's getting a little bad. We're overcome by the blood of the Lamb and by the
word.
I want y'all to say, maybe y'all know what I'm looking for. I'm looking for y'all to say that part with me. Because I think a lot of people are so hushed now of all the stuff that they've been through because they're ashamed. But we overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the
words
of our testimony. I'll take that. Words of wisdom. Thank you, dear. I appreciate that, man. Because I mean, God, don't think that we understand the power of that's part of that power of the resurrection.
Right. Amen.
It's a testimony.
Amen.
But people can look at you and you look good, you smell good, you drive good. Even if you're on hard times, you're still all the time smiling. And they might just say, well, that's just one of them Christian folks. they always been like that. They ain't really been through nothing. But all if the truth be told.
Yeah.
And we pull the skeleton out of the closet.
Amen.
We want to come off those that we've been through. Somebody can be helped.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right, Father.
God can speak to somebody through the pain that you've been through.
Yes, Lord.
Do we understand that there's power in that?
Power.
Yes, amen.
The fact that you didn't die in that thing.
Yeah.
And God saved you just so that you could be a test.
Test.
Come on, man. And we still.
By the words of our testimony.
Yes. By the words of our testimony. And look, I believe that this is so important because God is about to send someone to you.
Amen. Yeah,
right.
Did you hear what I said? He's going to send somebody to you that you can connect with and know that I can help this brother with the words of my testimony.
Amen. Amen.
And I hope that you just open up and sing like a canary. Tell them all the good, the bad, and the ugly.
Everything.
Yes. And let them know that there is still your victory. What if we didn't have a testimony of Job? A man that lost it all.
Oh.
Lost his children. His
yeah.
wife was tripping, right? He lost his cattle. He lost his camel. All his money. He's sitting by the fire, scraping his sores on his body with the potsherd.
Yeah.
What if we didn't have that testimony to know that what happened for Job after that? Mm-hmm. No. Couldn't compare it to what God had done before that.
Amen.
That's a testimony that we got there. What if we hadn't heard the testimony of David?
Amen.
Who tipped out and took another man's wife and got pregnant and all that. And God used him, still used him mightily, and said that because he knows how to repent, he's still a man after my own heart.
Yeah,
but if he didn't have that testimony.
That's right.
Amen.
He opened his mouth.
Come on, y'all. The Bible speaks the testimony of the people of God. And we have got to speak ours. What if we didn't have the testimony of Paul that said that he was imprisoned so many times? He was shipwrecked so many times. He was beaten so many times with 39 stripes, saying what? He had been through some stuff.
Amen.
But through it all, he said, all that stuff I count as dung so that I might win Christ.
Amen.
It's the testimony that does it for me, y'all.
Yeah.
And it's a testimony that's going to do it for somebody that's in your circle.
Jesus.
Mm-hmm. And when they saw that testimony, they were glad.
Yes.
When they saw the Lord. Sometimes you might be the only Jesus.
Come on.
Amen. Amen.
This old world will ever see.
Jesus.
But how will they see it if you don't open your mouth?
Amen.
How can you give them the gladness and how can you give them the hope if you don't open up your mouth?
Amen.
You say, you ain't the only one that's going through this.
Amen.
Amen.
You ain't the only one that's gone through the divorce. You ain't the only one that wants something and weren't able to get something. And just because God says no doesn't mean that, just because God says not now doesn't mean that he's saying no. But can you live that testimony in a way and give God glory?
Amen.
Mm-hmm. Verse 21 says, and then said Jesus again to them, peace be unto you.
Jesus.
As my Father, this is the part that kind of got me wrapped up and tangled up and tied up in this thing. As my Father has sent me, even so I send you. Knowing that Jesus was the first fruit of them that died. He was the seed that was sown. For us, right? And all those that took on Jesus and received Jesus, now we have become the fruit.
Amen.
And now he's sowing us. Are you prepared to be sown? Are you prepared to be sown?
Amen.
God is going to plant you in places that you never imagined that you would be.
Jesus.
Some place is going to be a joy for you.
Mm.
To where you can bloom where you planted, y'all. Right? And you can affect change. But some place that we're going to be planted are not going to be as beautiful as others. Some seasons where we're planted might cause us pain.
Yeah.
Some seasons where we're planted might have gray skies above. But we got to learn how to bloom even there.
Yeah.
We have to bloom where we're planted because God is looking for that harvest.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
He's looking for that harvest.
Yeah.
He's looking for that harvest. He's looking for that joker on the corner that just tried to sell you some crack. He's looking for that joker. He's looking for that guy that tried to sell me weed the other day. And I said, bro, I've been delivered from that. I don't do that anymore. You still there? God can change.
Amen.
Come on, we got a bloom of a planted and being planted. Everyone, people talk about planted. Talk about this planted in a church. Yeah, you have to be planted in a church, but you're planted in certain situations.
Yes, Lord. Yeah.
For certain times, for a time such as this. Yeah. What time is that? I said, whatever time God prayers you in front of somebody, we got to make sure that God is getting the glory out of our lives.
Oh, amen.
I wish I could preach it like I'm feeling, because my heart is just so heavy, because I want to know that people, I want people to understand that God, if you're a good seed, that God is sowing for a purpose. Amen. And that purpose is that he might get the harvest out of your life.
Yes.
But in order for you to do that, you got to die to what it is you're going through.
Yes. Amen.
You got to die to how you feel about what it is you're going through.
Yes.
And I know I'm just preaching this. It's easy to preach, but it's hard to live. Can I say it? It's easy to say it, but it's hard to do it. Been preaching for a while now, but I still got to catch myself. And sometimes I'm catching myself and pulling myself out of the ditch that I just fell into.
Come on, come on, bro.
Amen.
Because I should have humbled myself, right?
Yeah.
I should have died to my flesh in this situation. But sometimes the good that I do, my flesh is always. That's why we have to keep this flesh at the front.
Amen.
We got to keep this flesh. And not only that, if we try to get our own flesh under subjection, that's called behavior modification.
Amen.
Right? I tried to stop drinking so many times on my own. And I may dry up for about a week and then fall off the wagon. Might dry up for a month or so. Fall off the wagon. Might give it up altogether and find myself passed out somewhere, like I used to be passed out somewhere. But it wasn't until I received the power of the Holy Ghost in my life.
Yeah,
God to that thing. We try to do it all on our own, and you don't have it in yourself to do this thing.
Yes.
If you had it in yourself to do it, it would have been done a long time ago.
Yeah.
It's going to take something outside of you to affect change inside of you, that you might be able to be the righteousness of God, and God can get the glory out of your life.
Amen.
Somebody got to die.
Somebody.
Yeah.
That we may live.
That others may live. Thank you, God. Somebody got to die. For a good man, maybe somebody might die. Right?
Yeah.
But if we're supposed to live this life like Christ, who died?
Amen.
Because I see a whole bunch of live Christians around here. You're too live. What's the test of a dead man? If I come up to a dead man, what's the dead man going to do? If I come up to the dead man and say, your mama is so fat, what the dead man going to do?
Yeah.
We can't respond out of our flesh, because our life, not that we're dead and our life is hidden in Christ.
Amen.
So we have to figure this thing out. And the only way that somebody gonna talk about my mama and I don't come to their job is I got to have the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
That's the only way I'm gonna do it. I don't know about you. And I don't know what it is. It might not be your mom. It might not be your daddy. It might be something else. But we can't always react in the flesh to situations where God is saying, I need you to react in the Spirit of God that I have anointed you with and blessed you with, the seed of righteousness on the inside of you. And I'm looking for my return.
Amen. Right?
Amen.
Amen. I'm looking for my return. He wants to sow you to the hedges and the highways, that you might be able to show people who you are in God.
Yeah.
And they might be able to come to him.
Amen.
And say, Lord, I need thee. Oh, I need thee.
I need it.
Every hour. I need
yes,
it.
Lord.
Bless.
Yes.
Come on, say it. Come on.
What? I don't know to do thee.
I come to thee. That's what we're looking for. We're looking for that. That's, that is talking about the harvest that God has in your testimony.
Amen.
I don't want to be a dead horse.
Amen.
But I want you to understand that this is the power of the resurrection.
Amen.
22 says this. And when he had said this, he breathed on them.
Amen.
Y'all remember that old song? It goes together with another song about shine on me, let the light of the lighthouse shine on me. And then he says, my father-in-law said, breathe on me, breathe on me. Let the breath of the Lord now breathe on me. Because in the book of Genesis, when he created man in the ground, the man was a man, but he didn't have a living soul. A living soul. He didn't have a living soul until God did what?
Breathe up.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Breathe into him.
Amen.
All right, he breathed into him, and man became a living soul. But now Jesus walked into the room with all these scared jokers around.
Sure.
Fearing for their life. Feeling like they've given up their fishing business for this guy who hung on the cross, and now he's gone, and I don't know what we're going to do. And now I can't show my face where I used to be because now the people, now Rome is going to know who I am. And the people are going to see me and call me names and tell me that I was a fool. And they had given up hope. But now Jesus steps into the midst and he breathes on them.
Yeah.
He revives them.
Yeah.
He revitalizes them with the words of his mouth.
Yeah.
Sometimes we're not dead. We just need a little CPR.
Yes.
Good God.
We just need a little resuscitation.
Need a little something.
Yeah. We need a little something, right?
Yeah.
We just need God to come on the scene
yeah.
and just revive me again. Yeah. Lord. Just revive me again. Just speak the words of life over me one more time, Lord.
Yes.
I know that I may fail you, but breathe your forgiveness on me one more time, oh God.
Yeah, yeah.
I know that I might be over my head in this situation, oh God, but you told me that you would put me upon a rock that my head might be above all of my enemies. God, breathe on me one more time.
Yeah, yeah.
Somebody say, breathe on me, Lord.
Breathe on me, Lord.
Breathe on me in this situation. Breathe on me in this circumstance.
Yeah.
Breathe on me now, oh God. I need you, Jesus.
Amen.
Just breathe on me.
Yeah.
And he didn't just breathe on them, but the message that he was giving them let them know that I got you. And the way that I'm going to protect you, the way that I'm going to get you out of what you're into is not that I'm going to do it now, because I've done my part. I sat on the cross, I hung my head, I died, right?
Yeah.
And now he said, it is finished.
It is finished.
But I left you a word that is wrapped in the Holy Ghost.
Yeah, yeah.
Amen.
That's wrapped in the living spirit of God.
Yes.
That's now on the inside of every man, woman, boy, and girl that has received the gift of God in their life. That said, yes, God, I'll take your hand.
Yes.
You receive the Holy Ghost now to allow you to move the way God moves, to say the things that God said, do the things that God wants you to do, but it's only going to happen through the Holy Spirit of God.
Yes. Amen. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Holy Ghost.
Talking to somebody today, say, oh, y'all probably know apostolic over there. Y'all be shouting and getting the Holy Ghost and falling out and foaming at the mouth.
Uh-huh.
And the problem is that while, yes, that may be a gift of the Holy Ghost for somebody else, that ain't all the Holy Ghost is.
Amen. Amen.
And in some cases, that might not be the Holy Ghost at all.
Right.
If the truth be told, we can just be people right now, right?
Yeah.
That's because it's just us right here, right?
Uh-huh.
Sometimes that might, because anything that the devil can duplicate,
you'll do it.
Is not the truth. The true test of what is God and what is not God.
Amen.
But the true test of God, the true Holy Ghost power is that thing that leads you and guides you into all truth.
Amen.
Right? Amen. So the fact that I'm able to treat my neighbor right.
Yeah.
I know the devil ain't going to try to duplicate that.
Uh-huh.
Is he? So that's how I know I got it. Look, I ain't going to cheat on my taxes. I know I got 5 kids that belong to somebody else that I can write off on these taxes right now. Right? Get me to come up.
Because
I know who I am in God, I know that I don't need to lie about this because God will supply all of my needs.
Yeah.
It might be slow.
Yeah.
It might not be a big come up right at once.
Yeah.
But if I follow God, look, the return that we're looking for is not on this side anyway.
Amen.
Even though He will bless you on this side. You don't have to wait till you die to get the reward. He'll reward you right now.
Right now, yeah. Man.
But what does a profit a man to gain the whole world and lose his soul?
Amen.
Don't be afraid of them that can kill your body.
Yeah.
But the healing that can kill your body and put your soul in heaven.
Amen. Amen.
Somebody shout, I fear God.
I fear God.
That was kind of weak. I don't know if everybody believes that. So I fear God.
I fear God.
I fear Him.
Yeah.
Not only do I reverence God in the house, not only do I give Him the highest respect, but when I'm out of line, I fear God.
Amen.
Why you fear God, preacher? Because the Bible says that perfect love casts out all fear. And I say, yeah, His love for me is perfect. But sometimes my love for Him ain't perfect. And it's in those times when I realize that my love for Him is not perfect,
Amen.
I know that I'm putting my life in jeopardy.
Yeah.
And as a man, of a husband, as a father, I know when I'm out of line, not only am I putting myself in jeopardy, but I'm putting in jeopardy all those that
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I wish I could do a cartwheel right now.
Don't push me, though.
You got to give me a box of ibuprofen after I do this. That's what I want to do right now.
We got it.
But look, men, you have to know that when you're out of line, not only are you digging a ditch or a grave for yourself, but you digging it for your children.
Yes, you are.
You digging it for your sons.
Amen.
Digging it for your daughter. And I had to be, look, I used to work, in my day, the group that was out was NWA.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know y'all been saying
that. Yeah.
NWA was the rap group that was out. And I was all in. We know all the songs. And I get in my little Eagle Talon, my white Eagle Talon with the bubble in the back. And I'll be packing that music and ride down the street, windows down, and have my baby in the back seat.
Nicholas with an attitude.
Had my baby in the back seat, y'all. And I was getting out of the car seat one day, and she said something that she got off of that tape, and it crushed me. And I won't even tell you what she said. She said it to me with a smile on her face. Because she didn't understand what it was that she was saying.
Amen.
And I realized at that point, I've got to die.
Mm-hmm.
I've got to die to this thing that has such a hold on me.
Yeah.
I've got to die of this thing that's living in me and pushing me in direction. And I'm dragging my children and my people behind me. I'm killing them slowly. Because I don't want to die.
Amen. Yeah.
What is it in your life?
Oh, my goodness.
The enemy is losing, not just to kill you, but to kill the generations that come after you.
Yes.
It might be your slick tongue. It might be your cussing mouth. It might be your prideful attitude. It might be your greedy spirit. It might be your wandering eyes.
Yes.
Come on. It might be whatever it is, but whatever it is, you got to declare, you got to choose to kill it now!
Yes.
That the Spirit of God can be resurrected in your life. He can be resurrected in your life. And the quicker you grab a hold of this, the better off you'll be, y'all.
Amen.
That's where generational curses come.
Yes.
Somebody say, breathe on me, Lord.
Breathe on me, Lord.
Let me receive.
Let me receive.
The Holy Ghost.
The Holy Ghost.
The Holy Ghost is more than a running and shout. The Holy Ghost is living this life the way that God called you to live it.
Amen.
As a matter of fact, what the Holy Ghost does,
It gifts you with responsibility.
Yeah.
I wish this was a shouting message today on Easter. I wish it was, but it's a teaching message because I'm trying to get us to heaven.
Yeah.
When the Lord crack the sky and come back, and he take all his people together, I want us all to be on the sheep side and not on the goat side.
Amen.
All right. I want that's right. I want to be on the sheep side and not on the goat side because I said I'm the pastor. I have to give an account to what I'm teaching y'all.
Amen.
And while I do want to let you know, want to excite your soul, I need to let us know how to get to heaven.
Amen.
23 says this. Whosoever sins you remit, they are remitted unto them. And whosoever sins you retain, they are retained. And I didn't really understand exactly what that meant. So you mean if I forgive somebody, they're forgiven. And if I don't forgive, they're not forgiven. But I was reading it wrong. Because I don't think that the intention was that I would not forgive somebody that sins. The intention was, if you don't say it,
yeah.
If you don't preach it,
that's right.
If you don't cry it,
yeah.
If you don't declare it,
yeah.
No one will come to me.
Yeah.
They'll stay in their sin, and the blood will be required at your hand.
Amen.
Everybody think that's Old Testament, that's New Testament scripture.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't speak up, if you don't shout it, and somebody doesn't hear the word, when you had the opportunity, the blood will be required.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
As a matter of fact, it mirrors Acts 8:8, but he says, ye shall receive power. After that, the Holy Ghost has come upon you, and that power that comes upon you ain't the speaking tongue, it ain't the church flips, it ain't the foam in the mouth, but that ye shall be witnesses.
Yes,
sir. That's what the Holy Ghost does.
That's
what the Holy Ghost does. Yeah. That is the power of the resurrection that was done through the Holy Ghost of God by the Spirit of God to make us witnesses in all Jerusalem and in Judea, that men and women, boys and girls everywhere will hear the word of God, see it acted out, miracles, signs, and wonders, and come to know him in a special way.
Amen.
That's the power
Amen.
Of the resurrection. It's not just Jesus that has to be resurrected, but
Amen.
I got to be resurrected.
Amen.
You got to be resurrected.
Amen.
Y'all got to be resurrected
yes.
So that new life can come and yes. Jesus will get the glory.
Yes.
The Holy Ghost comes to give us the power of responsibility.
Mm-hmm.
And some of us are still so reckless with it.
Mm-hmm.
Still so reckless with it. We're not even giving back to God all that he's given unto us. That's reckless, y'all.
Amen.
That's reckless. He's given us responsibility of reproduction and multiplication. Right?
Amen.
If a corn of wheat doesn't die and fall to the ground, I'm doing it every verse because it said, if a corn of wheat dies and falls to the ground, it brings forth much. But if a corn of wheat does not die and does not fall to the ground, where's the harvest? Where's the reproduction?
Amen.
Where's the multiplication?
Amen.
And isn't that what God put Adam and Eve in the garden to do? Multiply.
Amen.
And replenish.
Amen.
And that same thing is to us today, y'all. We got to reproduce. We got to multiply. We got to replenish. The secret to the spirit of life through resurrection is the gift of that resurrection, which is only found through death. Right? And again, it's not physical death, but it's a spiritual death that we die to ourselves. Romans 8:11 says it like this, but if the spirit of him that raised up Jesus from the dead dwell in you, that he raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken these mortal bodies.
Amen.
By his spirit that dwells
in you.
Not only.
Amen.
Not on me anymore.
Not on me.
When Jesus came in the room and stood in the midst and breathed on him, he breathed on them. Because now you got to do something, or you got to do something, you got to receive something, you got to
to make a choice now.
Yeah.
So I'm going to give you the ability to make a choice, or strengthen you to make the choice. But after that, you got to do what you got to do, that God can do what he got to do.
Yeah.
With
you. God can do it.
It wasn't until the book of Acts where he told them to go into the upper room.
Yeah.
And they were all assembled.
Yeah.
They were on one accord.
One.
And suddenly there came a sound. Woo! Like a mighty rushing wind. Come on!
Yeah.
And the fire of cloven tongues sat on them all. And they begin to speak.
Yeah, yeah.
To speak.
Amen.
They begin to speak. Yeah. Is anybody speaking today?
Oh,
is anybody praying today?
Move on.
Is anybody sharing it today?
Move on.
Is anybody saying it today? Is anybody speaking the word of God?
Yeah.
Amen.
Come on, brother.
Because then it became something that he puts on the inside.
What?
It's no longer on us, but we can take that off.
Yes, it is.
You ever heard a Christian say, I'm going to take this Holy Ghost off one time, I'm going to tell you.
Yeah.
No. This is not something that you can take off and put on whenever you get a chance. You get ready to do it.
Uh-oh.
Now it's internal.
Yeah.
And it's to hurt you to move outside the will of God in your life.
Amen.
It ought to cost you something from the inside when you go against the laws of God. You ought to be crying in your spirit. God, I can't live like this, and I sure don't want to die like this. Breathe on me again. Give me the power to die to this thing.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I'm done, y'all. I'm going to read this.
We're
going to stand up. We're going to go home. Paul says it like this. He said it so beautifully. And I like to read out of the voice version of the Bible because sometimes it makes it so plain to me. It makes it so plain what he's saying. He says, in Philippians 3:10, read it down. Mark it in your Bible so you can go back and read it later. I use the Bible Gateway to get these different versions, but I always go back to the King James.
Amen.
All right? I'm an old school preacher, right?
Amen.
But it says this, I want to know him inside and out. I want to experience the power of his resurrection and join in his suffering shaped by his death. So that I may arrive safely at the resurrection from the dead. I'm not here, nor have I become perfect. But I am charging on to gain anything and everything that Jesus has in store for me. And nothing will stand in my way because he has grabbed me and won't let me go. The Holy Ghost is a keeper if you want to be.
Amen.
Oh my God. The Holy Ghost is a keeper if you want to be kept. He's grabbed me and he won't let me go.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, as I have said, I know that I have not arrived. But there's one thing that I'm doing. I'm leaving my whole life behind.
Yeah.
And putting everything on the line for this mission. I'm sprinting toward the only goal that counts. To cross the line.
Yes.
To win the prize. To hear God's call to resurrection life. Found exclusively. In Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Oh, amen. Amen.
Amen.
The resurrection means so much more to me today than just a story that's told
Jesus
on Easter.
Amen.
I realize that this is an everyday story that needs to be told. And it can't be told a lot of times in story form.
Amen.
But sometimes the loudest message that we're ever going to preach is not going to come from behind a pulpit. It's not going to come out of a microphone, but it's going to come from how we live and lead our daily life.
Amen.
Have you ever seen a raggedy Christian?
Ooh-wee.
Thump you in the head with the Bible every chance they get, like, no wrong have they done, and then you catch them, and then you're like, if that's God, not on you more. You have to understand that you are responsible. If you have the gift of God in you, now you're responsible. And even if you don't have them, you're still going to be held responsible.
Amen. Right. Amen.
For the choices that you make and for the choices that you don't make.
Yes.
Today, I want us to make a choice.
Make a choice.
I'm not calling it right now. for people that are going to come up and they need strength. I'm not calling you coming up because you need God to move in your life. I'm not calling for that right now. I'm not calling for that today. Because we can do that on our own in our own house. Or we can do that on another Sunday or another Wednesday. You call me and I'll lead you through that. But today, I'm calling for those that want to make a choice. Those that want to make a choice that, look, I've been living this life long enough in my own strength. I've been doing it my way long enough, and nothing has worked out. As a matter of fact, things have gotten worse and worse. I'm leading these people that God has placed in my house and in my home, and I'm leading them, but am I leading them to victory? Or am I leading them to hell? Lord, I need you to change my mind. The altar is open for all those that want to make that choice for Christ today. That's willing to say, you know what? I realize that I'm too alive in this thing. And I know that God is not going to share his glory with now joker. So today's the day that I need to move out of the way and be control of my life, Lord. The altar is open. The altar is open. The altar is open. The altar is open. I wish the old mother was in my old church was here so she could say, what you gonna do when the world's on fire? When the world's on fire, you won't be able to make a decision then. I'm not trying to make you come out of fear, but I'm trying to give you that responsibility that you have to do the things that you need to do and make the decision you need to make today. Yes. The day that you hear his voice, high at heart and not your heart, as in the day of the provocation.
Yes, Lord.
But you gotta open up your windows and heist up your windows and open up your doors and let Jesus in today.
Amen.
Yes.
The Bible says that when he comes back on that day,
yes,
he said, let them that are in the field, let them be in the field still.
Amen. Yeah, yeah.
Don't come to me then.
Yeah.
You have the time now. Mm-hmm. He said, let them that are on the housetop, on the rooftop, let them be on the rooftop still.
That's right.
Don't even come down because it's going to be too late by that time.
Yeah.
I'm hammering today. Because if God would come back today, would you be lost? He's given us all space and time to repent. We need to repent. But the only way that we're going to stay in God is if we have that Holy Ghost.
Amen. Amen.
If you don't understand what that is, if you still don't understand what that is, please catch me at the church.
Cool.
Take my phone number and we can talk about this thing. Because it's so important. You cannot leave here and not know what that is. You can't go another day and not know who the Holy Ghost is to you. If there's anybody here that wants to be saved, I'm hammering.
Amen.
If there's anybody here that wants to be saved today,
amen.
That doesn't mean that you're going to live perfect tomorrow.
That's right.
But that means that now that I'm saved, now that I receive the Lord, now I don't have to go through this alone. It's going to be hard. It's going to be rough. It might be touch and go, but I don't have to go through this alone.
Yes,
amen. Yes. And if I should die trying, if I should die receiving, it's better than dying without.
Amen, amen.
I don't want you to die without the Lord. I don't want you to die without knowing him as your Savior. I don't want you to die without knowing him in the fullness of his power, of his resurrection.
Yes, Lord.
If you're here today, last call. If you're here today, and you say, you know what, I may not understand it all, but I want to throw my hat in the ring.
Come on, though.
I want to know him.
Yes,
yeah. Mercy. Judge him, Lord.
Well, Father, we received your word on today.
Amen.
We are all men without excuse.
Yes, sir.
But I pray today that the resurrection power of Jesus Christ and settle in each and every one of our hearts.
Lord. Yes, yes, Lord.
That we might know you in the power of your resurrection.
Jesus.
And we know you in the fellowship of your suffering.
Yes, Lord.
God, breathe on us.
Breathe on me, Lord.
I need that CPR. I
breathe
need
on
that
me, Lord.
Mouth-to-mouth resuscitation. I need it, oh God.
Yes.
I need to feel your word
Let me
coursing
receive,
through my
Lord.
Veins, God, that I might have the strength
yes.
and the right to do all that you call me to do.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Father, if Thank in you. This life only we have hope,
Thank you, sir.
We are men yes, most miserable.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Give us the truth of your word.
Jesus.
That we know that even in this life, you're able to bless, you're able to heal, you're able to deliver for
yes.
the life to come, God. Mm-hmm.
Yes, Lord.
There's joy unspeakable.
Joy.
And yeah. for the glory.
Yes.
And I want that, God. I want it here.
Yes.
And I want it there.
Yes.
But God, help me to do the things that you call
help
me to do.
Help me, Lord. Help yes. me, Lord.
Holy Ghost.
Help me to live like I believe.
Help me, Lord.
Hey, help me to live like I believe.
Help me, Lord.
I don't want to say I believe in my life. When people look at my life, they wonder if I'm a believer. And I don't want that.
Yeah, yeah.
I want balance. I want congruency in my
yeah,
life.
Yeah.
I know that I'm yours and you are mine.
Yes, Lord.
So God, as you go home with us tonight, don't let us rest.
Jesus.
Don't let us get a good night's sleep.
Jesus.
Allow us to toss and turn on our beds.
Yeah.
Until we understand that we need you, Lord.
We yes. need you, Jesus.
And we receive you as our God.
Yes, Lord.
Mm-hmm. And those of us that have children in this house.
Yes,
yes, yes.
God, help us to set a godly example.
Yes,
Look,
Lord.
They can see me all day, but I came from pain.
Yes.
I came from trauma.
Jesus.
I didn't see this growing up, but God, I understand now that I don't want my children to have to go through the same stuff I went through.
Yes.
Lord. God forbid. God forbid. Save my babies, Lord. Save my children, God.
Yes, Lord.
I don't want them to taste the things that I've had to taste their whole life.
Amen.
I don't want them to bump their head on the thing that I bump my head on yeah. all my life. I don't want them growing up around the filth that I've grown comfortable in all my
yes.
life.
Yes.
Save,
yes.
My
yes. Yes.
Save my babies.
Yes.
Save my babies.
Yes.
Save my babies, Lord.
Yes.
Save my Jesus.
Yes. Jesus.
Save my Lord. Save my children, God.
Yes.
Save the children, oh God.
Yes, yes.
Keep them from the hand of the wicked one.
Jesus.
Jesus.
Keep them from the hand of the devil, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Know that it's my responsibility to present them before the throne of grace.
Jesus.
Bless us now as we leave this place.
Bless us, Lord.
But never your presence.
Yes.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Jesus, Jesus.
Word without end.
Yes.
Somebody say amen.
Amen, amen.
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 Amen. And amen.
Amen.
We're having the first Tuesday of every month, a Giving Tuesday. Our support is for KMAC expansion, technology support, training for pastors and elders, and scholarship and development ministries. We'll also ask for donations through Cash App, and then we'll also have a Zelle. So let's be a part of this. Serenity Christian Fellowship, we're having a Giving Wednesday. We're asking everyone to give what they can from $1 to $1,000 every Wednesday to help pay for a new roof on the church.
Amen, amen.
Thank you in advance
amen.
For your support. So we need to be a part of this for the, you know, the uplifting and the building of the building.
Amen.
For the, this is on every Giving Wednesday.
Every Wednesday.
Can I say something about that before we move on?
Yeah.
Pastor Wayne, would you want to talk to that right now?
I can.
Yeah, please do. Please do. I want people to understand where we are with this right now.
We're in the process to having to put on about $12,000 to $14,000 roof to maintain our insurance, to maintain our church. Mm-hmm. And we're going to do it.